guys, Gigi Najad here. Thanks for watching. Today I'm going to document in a really short video some of my competition journey at the Teen Collegiate and Masters Nationals in Pittsburgh in July of 2022. Now, this was my second competition. My first one is in the video entitled My First Bikini Competition, July 2022. Nice. In this video, I kind of go through everything I experienced while I was in Pittsburgh by myself. It was a last minute determination that my coach and I made together that maybe it's worth us just going to nationals and see how I do, see how I stand against the competition at a national level show. So as a master's competitor, all you have to do to qualify for nationals is have competed, which I did the week prior. And as I did that, my coach decided that, you know, as soon as I get back, which was Sunday, I drove back from Orlando, that Wednesday I hopped on a flight to Pittsburgh to compete at Masters Nationals. So the timeline kind of went like this, because check-ins for nationals are on Thursday of the weekend that nationals are taking place. I had to fly out that Wednesday night in order to not rush that Thursday in case there were any flight delays or anything like that that would prevent me from checking in on time. So Wednesday night, I got on a flight to Pittsburgh, checked into one of the remaining hotels because everything was booked out around the Sheraton Station Square where the competition was taking place. That hotel itself was booked out, of course, but also the surrounding areas. So what I did was book my hotel, which was directly across the bridge, and it was like a fifth of a mile to walk across the bridge and over to Station Square. So Wednesday I fly in, check into my hotel, and checked in with my coach. And then Thursday, he asked me to kind of check in throughout the day, and that was the day I think he was arriving. And then I had my final workout Thursday as well. So in the gym of the hotel that I booked, I made sure it had a gym. I went through my circuit workout and I did my cardio, which was 45 minutes or something like that. And then Friday I just chilled out, ate my meals, drank my water. There was no workout. I did walk a little bit on the treadmill downstairs, but as far as going around Pittsburgh, it's something I really wanted to do is see the city. I was told to stay off my feet, which I did. So then Saturday morning was the competition. So what ended up happening on Saturday is I woke up pretty early. My body didn't let me sleep. So I ended up just waking up around 4:30, 5 o'clock, starting my hair and makeup, having my coffee, my breakfast, and 4 ounces of water, just like my coach told me to do. And then once I was done with that, I packed up the rest of my meals, got on my suit, grabbed my heels, put on my jewelry, my sweats, and walked across the bridge. And that was super simple. There were a lot of competitors doing that. So I went and got my last coat of tan and then ended up going and sitting in the waiting room where all of the other bikini competitors were. And by the way, I had only been to one show backstage before. I'd only competed one time before, so I'd only seen the backstage at a regional level show, which I didn't even really know where I was going, so I ended up not even sitting in the bikini waiting room. But this time there was a giant room filled with a great number of very fit, beautiful women making little spaces for themselves with their coolers and their foods and all that stuff. So I found a little spot for myself right next to the tanning people. And I just sat and waited, and then it was super organized. They started calling the classes out, and I competed in 40A because I'm 5 feet and 35 plus A. So I had two chances to get up on stage in front of the judges, which was really cool. So I'm going to include the footage of my stage time next, and you'll get to see how everything rolls at a national level show. So the commentating that you hear is actually from the live stream, not the judges speaking. So I wanted to keep the commentators' notes about me in just to give you an idea of the things that they talk about and the things that they notice. So that will be included in the video, and I'll walk you through the rest. Just keep in mind, super short video because I don't have a lot of footage. I was there by myself, but I had a really, really great time. It was a really long trip for me being away from my kids for that long. But it was a really, really cool experience. And anybody who gets a chance to compete at nationals absolutely should take that opportunity, because you're challenged in a different way. You're challenged physically, of course, because you see your competition physically and you see kind of what's stacked up against you. But also you talk yourself through just being confident and giving it your best shot, because at the end of the day, let the judges do the judging. You are not the one that's judging the competitors. You're not judging yourself. All you can do is give it your best on stage that day in that moment. And that's what I did. And it was great. And I was super confident on stage. I loved my stage time. My coach was in the audience cheering me on. And I had a blast. It was actually a really, really good time. So I hope you enjoy the video. And thanks for watching.
So she has beautifully developed shoulders, and that's one of the benefits of also having short muscle bellies, is they can be a little bit easier to develop, and they just have that nice, beautiful, bubbly look. So I'm going to go ahead and star her name, because I feel like I call on them adding her in here. But you can see she's slowly working her way into the middle. Uh, 676, I feel like she could push her hips a little bit more forward just to give her more of that S curve, and show off her glutes more, because I feel like she's got more back there that she's not showing. And also she has a tiny waist, and I feel like she can accent that a little more, like 615, as you can see that her hip is really turned and her chest is to the front, which that creates a small waist. I mean, it's all about illusions here. But she does have more round shoulders. But from the backside, I feel like 615's got it. So we'll see when it comes.
And congratulations.
All right, so we have
735 and
our
678
first
switch,
call
please.
For Masters Bikini 35 and over A class. So we're going to go ahead and see our head judge, Tyler Mannion, move around the ladies to see who's going to be our top three.
And 736 switch, please. 736 and 734 switch, please. 736 and 733 switch, please. Face the back. face front.
So who really sticks out to me is 676 and 733. I would love to see those two put together to compare their, especially their backsides together, because they are comparable to me, at least in my opinion.
Thank you, ladies. You can file off to your right.
Oh, well, there we go.